Yes.
Yes.
This is our house now. So tonight, you guys just play loose. Enjoy it. Enjoy playing the way we play. Let's all go to work tonight, all right?
Welcome inside GCU Arena for the opening women's basketball game of the season between the GCU Lopes and the Alcorn State Braves. Lopes coming off a 68-48 win over Western State Colorado University in an exhibition game, their first home game of the season here in GCU Arena. Dewey, I know the girls are excited. I know I'm excited. What do we expect from the Lopes here tonight?
Well, you know, having an exhibition game 68-48 to Western State University, they've had a lot of stuff going on. And you know, we're going to go ahead and send it out.
Going to have the prayer and the national anthem right here.
Would you please remain standing as we honor America with the presentation of our national anthem. The Star Spangled Banner will be performed this evening by the Thunder Head Prep Band under the direction of Paul Cook and Associate Devin Barr.
And Dewey, as you were saying, first home game of the season for the Lopes. Going to be excited here for the game as the flag walks off the court. Girls are excited. We're excited. What can we expect from the Lopes today?
You know, coming back and already having had a game already, the Lopes kind of have an idea of what their strengths and weaknesses are. So we anticipate that they're going to have that ability to come out on the court tonight and use their strengths and not display as much of the weaknesses as they did as a team already.
Absolutely. Lopes' strengths come from down low and around the perimeter, scoring 9 three-pointers in that exhibition game against Western State Colorado University. And 19 of those points of the 68 coming from Marina Laramie, who's had a double-double, 19 points, 11 rebounds. We're going to go over the starting lineups here for the visiting team from Alcorn State, the Braves. They will start and surrounded by an all-SWAC preseason first-team player in Penny Wells. She averaged 5.1 points per game last year and 2.9 blocks per game. She's going to lead the team. She's joined by Brianna Luton, Alexis Freeman, Tia Sanders, and Miracle Rushing. Those are the 5-4 Braves. Now for the Lopes, number one, Anaya Baker. She's a redshirt senior from Paris, California, and she's come in from UC Davis, and she's going to be a force around the perimeter. She's a point guard coming in, and she's going to be joined by a forward down low, number 3, Marina Laramie. She had 19 points and 11 rebounds in that exhibition game against Western State. She's going to be a threat all night long. Jessica Gajewski is a three-point threat. She led the team last year in points. She had a career-high 28 points on December 8th against North Dakota State, and she's going to lead the team out wide. Laura Marcos Canedo is a transfer from University of Southern Florida. She played 25 minutes and 9 points in that opening game against Western State. And Tanisha Daniels, another forward. She's another returner, only 2 returners on the starting 5 today. She had 15.5 minutes per game last year, averaging 38% from the field. She had 2 points in that opening game. Those are your 5 starters tonight for the Lopes as they get ready to open up the season here at home. It's the Lopes and the Braves here from GSU Arena as the Lopes get ready for their first game of the season, the exhibition game, getting the rust off the bolts, the joints, and everything, and the Lopes are looking to continue their momentum into tonight's game and look to start early and start strong. Dewey, what exactly can we expect from Jessica Gajewski and Marina Laramie?
You know what? They're both powerful players. I watching them on the court, Gajewski, she is a powerful shooter. As long as we get her to get the ball and get her around into the court, she's going to be hitting those shots, and we need to get those points on the board.
She's definitely a threat from behind the arc, and she led the team in scoring last year, scoring 28 points back on December 8th, 28 points, a lot of points against North Dakota State. And Maria Laramie, who had 19 in that exhibition game over Western State, as we're just about ready to tip off here at GCU Arena for Lopes and the Braves. But Penny Wells down low for the Lopes is going to be a threat all night long. The Lopes will need to slow her down to be able to score down in the paint. Tipped off. It's going to go out of bounds. It's going to say off of the Braves, and the Lopes will have possession here to open up the game. Tanisha Daniels will inbound the ball. She averaged 15.5 minutes last year with 2.9 points per game and 3.4 rebounds. Canedo is going to get it down low to Marina Laramie. She's going to get the low block shot. She's going to put it in for the first basket of the game. Anaya Clark's going to steal the inbounds pass. And the Lopes have another possession here very early on. Canedo will slow things down at the point. She's going to be guarded by Tia Sanders. She's going to find Marina Laramie down on the wing. She'll dribble it back up, finding nothing down on the baseline. Little spin and hook there from the down low on the baseline. No good here. The Braves are in transition. Alexis Freeman with the ball.
That quick start for the Lopes is going to be an excellent advantage that they got going on. They have the speed and they have the focus more so than Alcorn State does.
Traveling is going to be called against Alexis Freeman. She's a 5'4 junior point guard from Blinn Junior College, originally from Novosota, Texas. She's going to be doing the point guard duties here along with number 20, Tia Sanders. The transfer from Spain, Laura Canedo, will take the ball up and find Marina Laramie. Offensive foul, however, is going to go against number 13, Laura Marcus Canedo. An illegal screen. Turnover here for the Lopes. Alexis Freeman bringing it up, looking for options here early in the first quarter. She's going to find Tia Sanders. She's going to shoot for a three-pointer. And she's going to drain it. Nothing but net. 3-2 lead here for Alcorn State here early after that three-pointer from beyond the arc. Canedo looking for her options. Dribbling it down to the baseline. She finds Marina Laramie wide open. The jumper is good. She's 2-for-3 tonight with 4 points already. Already off to a hot start. Marina Laramie is going to be a threat all day long for the Lopes.
Absolutely.
So you can see the ball getting worked around here on this replay. She just finds the open jumper, buries it. Ball out of bounds. It's going to stick with the Braves in their all-purple uniforms. Lopes all-white today. Alexis Freeman will inbound. Penny Wells hasn't touched the ball yet on offense, and she hasn't touched the ball on defense. And Anaya Baker with another steal here early in the game. Fast break opportunity. She's going to go to the line, though, as she gets fouled. Her shot no good. Naya Bakers played 35 minutes in that opener against Western State. She had 14 points. She was two for five from beyond the arc, along with two steals, and she's already matched her steals numbers here in the first quarter. The first free throw is no good. And a substitution for the Braves is going to be number 14, Brianna Tolliver, coming into the game. Second free throw from Anaya Baker on the way. It's no good. Offensive rebound, Maria Laramie. The Lopes will look to get some offense here on that offensive rebound. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Canado going to get by everybody. Drain to the lane. And her floater's no good. Out of bounds. And it's going to stay with the Braves. Tolliver getting guarded by Baker. Canado with another steal, and she's going to get the easy lay-in. Six quick points here from the Lopes, and three steals for the Lopes. It's going to be a defensive swarm and pressure all night long. They're never going to let up. No relentless. It's going to be relentless pressure all day from the Lopes.
Lopes defense seems to be gridlocked. Pretty intense going on right now. They're not letting anything get through.
Sanders to rushing. Foul down low against Thesha Daniels. Penny Wills had the ball down in the post. Yes. Thesha Daniels pushed Wells from behind. And Wells comes into the game averaging 5.1 points per game last year, but 2.9 blocks. That's going to be something to look for here in the opener. Thesha Daniels gets a steal on the inbounds, and the Braves can't control the ball here early on in the first quarter. Baker out wide left. Gets a screen from Laramie. She's going to pull up atop the key. The shot is no good. Over the back, offensive foul against Thesha Daniels, and that's her second. Rarick is going to come in for Daniels here in the first quarter. 55 on the clock. Rarick played 12 minutes in that first game, only had 1 point, coming off of a free throw, going 1 for 2 from the line. She also had an assist. She was a leading point scorer last year for the Lopes. Lopes will need her. They did not have her last year. She was coming off an injury. We'll look to see how she does here as a redshirt sophomore.
And again with this Lopes defense, I mean, they're focused so well on this Alcorn State team right now.
That was number 12, Brianna Luton with the shot. Clanking off the iron a couple times, then falling. Nobody able to collect it. It goes out of bounds. The Braves will get the ball. Inbounded to number 25, Miracle rushing. And Tolliver will hold the ball up, guarded by Baker. Baker inching closer. Braves looking for a play here in this 2-3 zone. Down to the corner, Tolliver with the ball. Tolliver shoots and it's missed. And then a steal by number 14, Brianna Tolliver from Laramie. She puts it up and then is fouled by Laramie. She'll go to the line shooting two. Tolliver was 70.7% from the line last year on 20 minutes per game. She averaged 6.5 points per game, and she misses her first. Here, Lopes have a 6-3 lead here in the first quarter. Tolliver's second is good. Got the lead to two here early in the first quarter. Laramie will inbound to Canado. Interesting call, but the Lopes retain possession. Laura Marcos Canado bringing the ball up. She's guarded by Sanders. Baker looking for her option. She finds Kajewski. Her pass is intercepted, but then Rarick gets it back. Kajewski with the ball, finds Canado. Canado's three-pointer attempt is good. Count the bucket and the three. She's going to go to the line. for a four-point play the old-fashioned way.
That's absolutely correct.
Canedo going to the line after her three-pointer was made. And the four-point play the old-fashioned way, even though there used to not be a line, so it's a little bit of a play on words there. But 4 points there from Canedo here on her three-pointer that was made and the foul. Tolliver taking it to the rack but missing it. Tia Sanders' three-point attempt is no good. Offensive rebound, but the ball goes out of bounds off of Penny Wells, and Wilkes will get the ball back.
Seems that Alcorn State is realizing that GC was pressing really hard on their defenses, so they're trying to take a lot of shots from behind the arc, and they're not really getting the ball to where they need it to be. I mean, the Lopes are passing and getting the ball around and hitting all these shots, getting as many points on the board as they can. Well, Alcorn State is not necessarily focusing on that same goal.
Loose ball on the ground there on that far side in the left corner. No foul called. The Braves will retain possession. Tia Sanders will inbound the ball. Brianna Tolliver bringing the ball up the floor. Crushing half-court press there after the ball gets over the mid-court line. Relentless pressure from the Lopes as soon as the Braves get it across the half-court. August Touchard checking into the game after Tolliver's first free throw. Tolliver drains it. Touchard comes in for Baker. Baker with no points in the game. Laramie with four. And Marcos Canedo with six after her four-point play, getting fouled on a three-pointer. Tolliver drains the free throw again. She has 3 points. Sander with 3 points. Those are the six total. Rarick wide open. She's going to find Laramie for the open jumper as well, and Laramie now has six here early in the first quarter. About halfway through the first quarter. 4:45 on the clock. Kirkland, and traveling is called against Tolliver. Lopes get the ball back. That's going to bring us to a timeout here. The Lopes open up a 12-5 lead here early against the Braves.
All right, Lopes.
GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Welcome back to GC Arena. Lopes opening up a 12-6 lead here on the Braves after 6 points from both Laramie and Marcos Canedo. Laramie just being wide open all the time down on that low block. What's been working for the Lopes?
The Lopes have, the defense is absolutely gridlocked. The All-State not getting through at all. And they having Laramie open on that in that part of the court right there in the center, she's just laying these buckets in. Just down, down, down. No problem at all.
Unguarded down on that low post. The Lopes using good ball movement to get open shots for the Lopes. Canedo getting that three-point attempt. She was fouled on. She got it to go. Went to the line. Drained her free throw attempt as well. Lopes got 4 points out of it. You don't see that very often. Canedo was pumped up here early in the first quarter. 4:40 on the clock after this timeout. Lopes have opened up a 12-6 lead. They're going to look to improve that and increase that margin throughout the entire rest of this quarter and into the second quarter before halftime. What are the Lopes going to do to get other people scoring goals? It's only been two people for the Lopes.
Right. Honestly, the Lopes just got to be able to pass the ball. Got to get the ball around to all the other players. They're looking for who's open. Nobody's really moving. Nobody's getting open, really. And we got to be able to get a lot more players open so we can go to that bucket.
Canedo to Rarick. Rarick's pass to Laramie. She's going to get another jumper on the baseline. This time it's no good. Back. Braves moving the ball around the perimeter. Down in the corner to Tolliver. Tolliver tries to find Wells. Takes the deflection. Kirkland with the ball. Sanders. Sanders' shot off the backboard and off the rim just as the shot clock was going off. August Tuchard with the ball now. Canedo retains the ball. And gets the point guard duties. Transfer from South Florida. Foul is going to be called against the Braves. Number 3, Penny Wells from Memphis Catholic High School. She's a senior. Rushing back into the game for the Braves. Inbounds is off of Laramie, but it's going to stay with the Lopes. Canedo inbounding the ball. August Tuchard trying to get open. Kajewski as well. Rarick, slow developing play. Rarick's shot is off target. Rebound, Kirkland. Tolliver bringing the ball up the court as she crosses midcourt. Guarded by Canedo. Lopes out of their 2-3 zone into a 1-3-1 zone now. Canedo guarding Sanders. Kajewski guarding number 12, Luton. Shot from the baseline. Rebound, offensive rebound for number 25. Miracle rushing, but her shot's off target. Laramie bringing the ball up the court. Canedo slowing things down after Laramie wanted to go quickly. She gets the pick from Laramie. She's going to take it to the rack. She's going to drop that one in there. Her 8th point of the game after that basket. Great pick there from Laramie. She gets the ball at the top of the key. Canedo takes it, gets around her screen, and takes it to the rack, puts it in.
A lot of good ball movement from Canedo.
Smothering defense there by Rarick. And it's going to be a foul against the Braves, number 12, Luton. Great defense there from Rarick. Get her hand in the way. Inbounds play here for the Lopes. August Tuchard is going to inbound to Canedo. August Tuchard coming off of a redshirt year after getting injured in the first game of the season. She has a career-high 19 points coming back from her sophomore year. Laramie Tuchard. Offensive foul against Laramie. And the Braves will get the ball back. Alexis Freeman bringing the ball up the floor. 5'4 guard from Blinn Junior College. Attacking quickly and against Laramie. Good defense there from the Lopes. Tuchard with the defensive rebound. Canedo will bring the ball up. Canedo finds Kajewski. Kajewski to Laramie. Lopes moving the ball well here. Looking for an open option. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Laramie with the ball. 6 on the shot. And a foul against number 25. Miracle rushing. And the shot clock will reset here for the Lopes. Number 20, Vanessa Murphy getting ready to come in. A freshman from Xavier Prep just down the road here in Phoenix, Arizona. Laramie will get 2 shots at the free throw line. She's going to miss her first one. Laramie went 2-for-2 from the free throw line against Western State. She had a double-double with 19 points off 8 shots, hitting 1-3 early in the first quarter. She also had 4 steals, but she fouled out late in the game after 31 minutes. Second free throw is no good for Laramie as well. Rushing with the rebound. Freeman bringing the ball up. Looking to work quickly. Freeman with the ball down low. Sanders, and her shot is good. Tia Sanders' 2nd basket of the game. She had a 3-pointer early, and that was the first lead for Alcorn. A 3-2 lead after Sanders' 3-pointer. August Touchard slowing things down. She's going to get a pick from Laramie. Going to try to get to the rack. She's going to pass it out to Rarick in the corner. Her three-pointer is good. Her first make of the contest. Quickly moved up the court by Freeman. Her shot and layup is no good. Canado finds Touchard. Touchard to Laramie. And then Canado will slow things down. 18 seconds on the shot clock. 48 on the main clock. Canado getting the ball all the way to the 10, and she's going to put it in. She's got 10 now here in this contest. Already in double-digit points, and it's only the first quarter. What are we seeing from Canado today?
She is using a lot of excellent ball movement, ball handling. She's reading her team really well, and when she can't, when she knows that they're all occupied, she just goes for it. She takes that shot. She's confident with it.
Sanders' three-pointer is off the mark. Offensive rebound by number 25, Miracle Rushing, transfer from East Central Community College. Rushing to the rack. Traveling is called against Rushing. And she rushed her attempt to the basket before she dribbled the ball. Can't walk with the ball. You got to dribble the ball. Turnover there with 9 seconds on the clock here in the first quarter.
Alcorn State's trying to keep up with GCU right now. They're trying to keep that same level of speed, and it's kind of tripping them up a little bit, not being able to stay with them on that level.
Canado goes coast to coast, draws the foul on the shot, and she'll go to the line shooting two here with 3 seconds on the clock. 19-8 here. GCU's opened up an 11-point lead against the Braves and looking to extend that lead here at the stripe here by Canado. Canado now has 11 after that made free throw. She's 2-for-2 from the line thus far. Canado 3-for-3 from the line. She has 12 with 3 seconds left on the clock. Freeman's half-court shot off the backboard, no good, as the Lopes end the first quarter up 21-8 off of Canado's 12 points here on GCU TV.
Project with GCU called Finding Kingdom's Purpose, and I have some questions from you guys that I'm going to answer, so let's get started. I was born and raised in Scottsdale, Arizona. Business management, but I now added a minor in marketing. Or my celebrity crush right now would probably be Dave Franco. I don't know if you could count it a hidden talent, but I can. My cousin, my sister, and I, we were the Powerpuff Girls, and so I was Blossom, and that's all the questions that we have, so thank you for watching.
Welcome back to GCU TV here. Fletcher Like alongside Dewey Jeffries. Dewey, 12 points from point guard Laura Marcos to Canado. What are we seeing in her 12-point performance here early after one quarter play?
Like we were saying before, she's got excellent ball control. She's taking the ball. She's reading the group, the team, and she's not rushing any decisions. She's making sure that if she can pass the ball, she's passing it. If she can't, she's like, you know what, I can take this, I got the ball, and she goes and takes it and is confident with her shot. Puts it in there every single time.
Absolutely. The Lopes utilizing every second of the shot clock. They haven't had a shot clock violation yet, but they're getting outstanding performances from Laramie and Canado, as well as Rarick, who drained a three there at the end of that first quarter to open up a 21-8 lead here against the Braves from Alcorn State. The Alcorn State Braves are led by number 20, Tia Sanders, who made that three-pointer early in the first quarter. She just got a bucket there late in the first. She has 5 points to lead the Braves. She has 5 of their 8 points.
Yeah. You know, like we were saying before, Alcorn State, they really are trying to keep up with GCU right now. GCU is keeping a fast-paced ball game right now, and it's all over the place.
Jump ball is going to be called on the floor. Vanessa Murphy going to the floor there, and the Lopes will get the ball here in the second quarter, 9:48 on the clock. Touchard, Rarick, Baker, Murphy, and Alex Bloom on the floor here to open up the second quarter. Baker gets the ball. He's going to find Murphy. Rarick for three. Her shot off the iron, out of bounds, and the Braves will get the ball after the miss by Rarick. Rarick had 1 point against Western State 0-for-3 from beyond the arc, 1-for-2 at the line with an assist. She already has a three here in the game. Miracle rushing with a shot, no good there. Rebound by Murphy. Baker sends it back out to Touchard, coming back from a season-ending injury last year. She's back here for a redshirt junior year. Alex Bloom, who came on late in the season last year, she was a late bloomer, and she's got the ball up top right now. 6 seconds in the shot clock. August Touchard for three, in and out there from Touchard. Sanders with the ball. She's going to get the ball to number 23, Tori Spann. Her layup is no good. Touchard out to Bloom. Waiting for the play to set up. Rarick cut into the basket. It's going to be kick ball off of Tia Sanders' left foot. Two substitutions coming in for the Lopes. Jessica Gajewski and number 3, Marina Laramie, coming in for Rarick and Bloom. Lopes will get the inbounds pass. Just on top of the V over there on University here at GCU, Grand Canyon University, here in Phoenix, Arizona, inside GCU Arena. August Touchard to inbound. Lopes waiting for their play to get started. Vanessa Murphy getting the ball off the inbounds play. Looking for Baker. Foul on that far side. Touchard had set a screen for Murphy, and she got leveled there by a Brave. That'll put the ball back on the post, and the Lopes will inbound. Nothing working for the Lopes. Offensive foul this time against number 3, Marina Laramie. And she now has 3 fouls. She fouled out last game. She already has 3 fouls here early in the second quarter. Is that something to look for here against the Braves?
Absolutely, as we just had number 32 come in for her. The coach is definitely looking to see Marina Laramie utilize her excellent shot later on in the game when it's necessary, and so we're taking her out of the game now, so we keep her out.
Another traveling called here against the Braves. That was number 14, Brianna Tolliver, and 6.5 points per game last year as a freshman. 5'8 sophomore from Lancaster High School in Dallas, Texas. Baker guarded by number 15, Alexis Freeman. Gajewski gets a screen from Murphy. Baker will bring things back out, cross up Freeman, and get a shot off. Great shot there from Anaya Baker, off balance. And time will be stopped. And Sneisha Daniels is looking for something in her finger, that's her contact. She's looking to put that back in. And we'll get a little delay here as Tanisha Daniels gets some water to put that contact, get that contact a little bit wet, get some contact cleanser as well. And it's going to be a little timeout here for the Lopes as we wait for Tanisha Daniels to get her contact back in. She's a trooper. She gets it back in, flicks her eye a little bit, and we're going to be ready to play here with 8 minutes left on the clock. A little 10-20-second unofficial timeout there for the Lopes and the Braves. Freeman to bring the ball up the floor. Freeman trying to get around Baker, but she can't. She finds Tolliver. Tolliver to Luton. Luton working on Touchard. Sends it back out to Spann. Spann to Freeman, guarded by Baker. Number 12, Spann, throws the ball away. Great defense there from the Lopes late in the shot clock, and they force a turnover here in the second quarter for the Braves.
Absolutely, with that 2-3 zone that they had, there was no getting around it, no getting through it.
2-3 zone, utilizing the strength of Anaya Baker up top to really smother the smaller guards here for the Braves. Braves with one player on the floor that's above 6 feet. That's number 12, Penny Wells. She's technically off the floor right now, as number 11, Alexis Holloway, is in. Listed at 5'9". The Lopes give the ball away to the Braves. 23-8 lead for the Lopes, led by Marcos Canedo with 12. Laramie has 6, but she's off the floor right now. Freeman slowing things down. She likes to go fast. Free-flowing offensive player, 5'4", from Blinn Junior College. She gets past Baker. Her little teardrop is going to fall there. 10 points now for the Braves here in the game. Tanisha Daniels wide open, takes it to the rack, and she's going to get that one to fall. A little fast break points there for the Lopes.
Excellent passing to get the ball around the Braves. And Tanisha getting the ball in.
Baker guarding Freeman. Hand checking there from Baker. And Baker will come out for Casey Rarick. Number 11, Alexis Holloway checks out. Number 25, Miracle Rushing checking back in for the Braves. Freeman to inbound. She finds number 23, Tori Spann. Ball goes out of bounds off of a Lope, however. Freeman to inbound yet again. She gets the ball in to Rushing. Rushing it, takes it to the rack and draws a foul. Blocking foul against the Lopes. She'll go to the line shooting 2. Fouls against Tanisha Daniels down low on the block. Number 25, Miracle Rushing, will go to the line. A transfer from East Central Community College. And the Braves are looking for scorers here in the 2016-2017 season after their leading goal point scorer, Noriana Hayes, graduated and is playing professional basketball over in Europe. She finished last season with 19.9 points per game. Was one of two players with over 70 rebounds. Braves really looking for scoring here in the 2016-17 campaign. Murphy gets the rebound off of Miracle Rushing's missed free throw. Out of bounds is going to be called against Canedo. It's going to be a foul, however, actually, against number 15, Alexis Freeman. Referee pointed to the line as if Canedo had stepped out of bounds. He's going to signal a foul against Freeman.
Seen a little more aggression on both teams, actually, as the speed of the game is still pretty high. Both teams are pretty aggressive in trying to get the ball down to the net.
Gajewski passes to Canedo. Canedo is tripped, but no foul is called. Inbounds for the Braves. Tolliver will bring the ball up. Sophomore guard from Dallas, Texas. Braves swinging the ball around and will look for something here in the corner through Rushing. Kirkland with the ball up top. Back down to Rushing, guarded by Murphy. Looking for something, doesn't find anything. It's going to be a traveling called. Great defense there by the freshman in number 20, Vanessa Murphy. Rarick will inbound here off of the traveling violation by number 25, Miracle Rushing. Smothering defense here by the Lopes so far.
It's definitely been their high point of this game so far, as how strong and how gridlocked their defense is. They're not letting a whole lot get through. Whether they're in 1-3-1 or 2-3 zone, they are able to keep the Braves from getting down into the net. They're forcing them to shoot the ball from around the arc.
11 turnovers here for the Braves, 4 in this quarter. And that just goes to show the defense that the Lopes are bringing here every single second and every single possession the Braves have. The Lopes are led by Marcos Canedo, who has 12 points. She hasn't had a basket in a while, though. And Laramie's off the floor right now with 3 fouls. Baker also has 3, and those two players are in foul trouble. here as the referees are explaining things here in the second quarter. 5:56 on the clock. Gajewski still hasn't made a basket. She hasn't even taken a shot. She's tried to get open looks, but she just hasn't had anything open for her, but she's going to go to the line here on a technical foul. She's going to drain the first shot that she makes. She now has a point here in the game. The second technical free throw is good from Gajewski. And Gajewski hit 92.7% of her free throws last year. And that just goes to show the dedication she has. Even when she's not scoring, she's going to be a clinical finisher at the line. Lopes break this press from the Braves. Gajewski's wide open. Her first official shot is good. She has 4 points here in the course of 10 seconds. And if Gajewski can get rolling, then the Braves are in trouble. When Gajewski gets going, the Lopes get going. And when Laramie's off the floor, the Lopes have to look for scoring in some other way when Canedo hasn't been able to make a basket in a while.
With Gajewski with that technical, Alcorn State definitely gave GCU that advantage, giving Gajewski the chance to get started and get her momentum flowing in this game.
Foul is going to go against Casey Rarick as Murray Miracle Rushing will go to the line, shooting two. 5:25 on the clock. Lopes lead 29-10. Last field goal made by Alcorn came at the 7:03 mark. And jumper by Alexis Freeman make it 10-23. Lopes are led by Marcos Canedo with 12 points. Laramie has 4 rebounds, and Casey Rarick has 2 assists. As the Lopes have a 17-point lead here, just about midway through the second quarter. Tanisha Daniels gets the ball at the elbow. Finds Gajewski. Gajewski to Vanessa Murphy. Turnaround J is no good off the mark. And the Braves are looking to push here quickly. Luton with the ball, going to the rack. Blocking foul against Tanisha Daniels. The Lopes bench is not happy about that one. Luton will go to the line now, shooting two. Luton was 500 from the line last year in 22 and a third minutes played, averaged 4.1 points per game. As number 24, Kiara Clark gets ready to check in. She's coming in for Tanisha Daniels. Daniels, Baker, and Laramie all with 3 fouls here in the game. Laramie's only played 10 minutes. Lopes are looking for scoring and foul discipline here in the second quarter. The Lopes have a 29-14 lead here at GCU Arena. Don't go anywhere here on GCU TV.
Grand Canyon University's newly remodeled golf course is thriving in the heart of Phoenix, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways, signature par threes, greenside bunkers, premium greens, and a brand new clubhouse and restaurant. Experience a university championship golf course this summer with great rates as low as $15 available now. Book your tee times at gcugolf.com.
Welcome back to GC Arena. Lopes have a 29-14 lead here over the Alcorn State Braves. The Lopes have been getting offensive production from Laura Marcus Canedo, but she's not been able to score lately. Gajewski going to the line, shooting 2 technical fouls after a technical was called against the Braves bench. She then drained an open look on a fast break opportunity. She now has 4. Laramie, though, along with Tanisha Daniels and Anaya Baker, 3 starters for the Lopes, already in foul trouble with 3 fouls. What do we expect from the Lopes here? And do we get to see a deep bench, or do we see a struggling bench here off the bench for the Lopes?
You know, I feel like they're not struggling at all. We're going to have the Lopes bench is still going to be able to pull in those points because they have excellent shooters. With Gajewski out there now, after the technical and after the open shooter, we have somebody who's out there being able to get open and make these shots in high-pressure points just like this. And with Canedo, once we get back in the momentum, the Lopes will be able to get the ball around to her and get her the ball or get Gajewski the ball. But having both of them on the court at the same time, the Lopes are dangerous.
Casey Rarick and Vanessa Murphy, those 2 threats off the bench for the Lopes as the Lopes inbound here to Canedo. to open up the second 5 minutes of the second quarter. Canedo getting past two defenders quickly, and then she gets fouled from behind there by a Brave. The Braves are looking to improve in first game situations. Offensive foul against the Lopes on the inbounds play, however. The Braves are 1-5 in their last six season openers, snapping a five-game losing streak last year in a win over Delta State. And they're in their first game against a WAC opponent ever. Traveling is called there on the other end, and the Braves give it right back to the Lopes. And as we said, the Braves were looking for scoring, and Brianna Tulliver might be the way. She scored 10-plus points in eight games last year. Foul is against number 12, Brianna Lutton. And Casey Rarick will go to the line here as they're in the bonus. Rarick played 12 minutes in the last game against Western State, Colorado University. One for two from the line. Canedo will inbound the ball. Not a bonus situation here yet for the Lopes. Canedo inbounding the ball. She finds Rarick. Rarick working against rushing. Rarick gets the ball back from Canedo. Finds Murphy up top. 19 seconds on the shot clock. Canedo slowing things down yet again. Gets a screen from Murphy, gets around it, now is guarded by number 24, who's not on the roster. Canedo getting around her defenders, finds an open. Kiara Clark, her shot is no good, hitting nothing but the backboard on the other end. Braves pushing Kirkland to the rack. Blocking foul, down low against Murphy. And Kirkland will go to the line after that threatening penetration there by the forward and guard in Asia Kirkland. Kirkland, a freshman from Clovis West High School in Fresno, California. Her first free throw attempt is no good. August Touchard checking into the game for number 24, Kiara Clark. Second free throw from Kirkland is on the way. Rebounded by rushing. Smothering defense down low. Foul called again, this time by number 11, Casey Rarick. The Braves have six conference titles dating back to 1986 when they got their first one. Title in 86, 91, 92, 2000, 2001, and 2005. Going to the NCAA tournament in 2000, 2001, and 2005, losing all three of those games. The first one in 2000, losing 95-53 to Louisiana Tech, then to Notre Dame, and then to Michigan State. Two formidable opponents in the sport of basketball in Notre Dame and Michigan State. Notre Dame, a powerhouse in women's basketball, and their men's team is coming onto the scene as a powerhouse in the ACC. Timeout on the floor by the Braves. Lopes have a 29-15 lead here at GCU Arena, led by Marcos Canedo with 12 points.
GCU is the university that never sleeps, moving at the speed of light. And now GCU is leading in the area of computer science and IT. With over 200 university degree programs across nine colleges, on campus and online, join the most inventive concept in education today. Fast track options available with courses in cybersecurity, cloud computing, and systems architecture. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/IT.
Welcome back to GCU Arena. Lopes have a 29-15 lead over the Alcorn State Braves. August Touchard to inbound here shortly. Lopes are led by Canedo with 12 points as the Braves are going to apply some full court pressure here in the second quarter. Lopes get it past half court to Murphy and then to Touchard. Pinedo will get the ball and slow it down. She's going to penetrate to the rack and then curl her way back out around. Lazy pass there to August Duchard. It luckily is not picked off there by the Braves. Number 23, Tori Spann. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Foul is called as Canedo shot down low. Was no good. She's going to go to the line shooting two, however. Foul coming against number 24. Number 14, Brianna Tolliver. Tolliver, one of those players the Braves are looking to provide scoring. Scoring 10 points in 8 games last year. And Tori Spann scored 10 points or more 6 different times last year. Spann and Tolliver, the two of the Braves will be looking forward to score a lot of points here for the Braves in the SWAC and in their non-conference slates.
Alcorn State's been doing a pretty good job with evaluating this, slowing the Lopes down, doing their full court press, and upping their accuracy with their passes on offense. They've been able to get around the Lopes just a little bit.
Jump ball is called after Tushard and Rarick applied smothering defense. Nothing that number 23 Tori Spann could do there. Absolutely great defense there from the Lopes, getting all over Spann, not committing a foul, then Rarick getting in there and grabbing the ball and forcing the jump ball. Braves keep the ball. No call there as Murphy went to the floor after accepting contact. Shot is good from Sanders. Little bucket there from Sanders. Her third basket of the game. She now has 7. She leads the team in scoring here for the Braves. Kajewski getting the ball. She's guarded by number 24. Canedo guarded by Kirkland. Gets a screen from Murphy. She gets around rushing. Finds Tushard wide open for 3, and it's good. August Tushard for 3, her first basket of the game. Her second three-point attempt. She drains it here. Open up the lead to 33-17. Shot from number 24 is no good. She gets her own rebound. Brings it out to rushing.
Shots like Tushard just had are exactly what we need from the Lopes right now. That slow, thought-out process of getting the ball to the right person at the right time.
Sanders' three-pointer is no good. Off the back iron. Foul is called against the Braves, and the Lopes will retain the ball. Foul coming against number 25, Miracle Rushing. She now has 2 fouls in the game. 3 points as the Braves are led by Sanders, who has 7. She has 3 made field goals along with 2 rebounds. Canedo will go to the line, shooting 2. She's 4-for-5 from the line thus far in the game. 2 minutes left on the clock in the second quarter and in the first half. Canedo's first free throw is good. She has 14 now for the Lopes, leading the team. Now that makes that 15. 6-for-7 from the line. 3 assists and a rebound to add and go along with 14 points. 15 points for the Lopes. Lopes defense forces another turnover. Alex Bloom with a steal after the Braves were going over and back over on the line. No call. And Casey Rarick will take it to the rack and slide one off the backboard from a thin angle. She now has 7 in the game.
Lopes are bringing that speed right back onto this court. Making Alcorn State and Braves have to think a little bit quicker on their feet.
Another travel is called against the Braves, this time against Asia Kirkland. Another turnover here for the visitors. They now have 15 turnovers here in the game. 7 coming in this quarter. Vanessa Murphy looked for that one. She decided not to take it. Outside, Rarick getting the ball, working against number 32. Jada Hargrove. Tushard to Rarick. Rarick for 3. And that one's going to rattle around and sink down to the bottom of the net. End of the floor. A 3-pointer there for Casey Rarick. 40-17 here in the final minute of the game, first half. made basket for number 30, Kirkland. Vanessa Murphy trying to swap that one away. Tishard brings it up. 35 seconds on the clock, 22 on the shot clock. Tishard gets the ball, finds Bloom. Bloom came on to be an offensive threat for the Lopes last year. Rarick getting the ball, driving, finds Bloom to Gajewski. Gajewski's little floater bounces around a couple times and does not fall. A slow night here for Gajewski. Kirkland for three. She'll bury that one with 5 seconds left on the clock here in the second quarter. And the Lopes will just let that one sliver all the way down to 0-0 on the clock. 40-22 lead here for the Lopes against the Braves. Lopes led by Marcos Canedo with 15 here at the end of the first half. Lopes up 40-22 here at GC Arena.
Finding the right college isn't always simple. The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to GC Arena. It's halftime here. The Lopes lead 40-22 off of Canedo's 15 points. Second best score for the Lopes. Casey Rarick, who has 8 points, as Marina Laramie has been held just 6 coming off. And she's on the bench right now after she had 3 fouls early through the first quarter and about a half. She's now on the bench as the Lopes lead 40-22 here from GC Arena over the Alcorn Brave States, State Braves. It's Dewey, what are the Lopes doing well here in the first half? We know that their defense has been smothering. Has that been the difference maker here to open up an 18-point lead?
Honestly, it was the initial difference maker. What's going on now is that the Lopes are syncing up together a little bit. They're making their team focus more together. They're getting the ball passed around. When they have Casey Rarick, when you have Jessica Gajewski open for any of those shots, getting the ball to them when everybody else is covered, for them to have that open shot to dunk that ball right in there, everybody gives them the points that they need to win this game.
Absolutely. The Lopes led by the Lopes. Marcos Canedo, point guard for the Lopes, 15 points. But the different story, 14 turnovers for the Braves here through the first two quarters of play. Smothering defense, relentless defense from the Lopes to force those 14 turnovers to lead to 40 points total in this contest. And a lot of that is due to the fact that they're forcing turnovers and the Braves haven't been able to hold onto the ball for very long.
And that also goes into the speed at which this game is being played. Lopes are playing fast-paced and really aggressively on offense and on defense. And having the Braves have to keep up with them and try to match that speed, the Braves are not exactly meshing with that exact level of what they're doing. So it's tripping up the Braves a little bit, making their focus kind of shift to not be on that same level as the Lopes are.
And the Braves have made open opportunities. They've had opportunities in the corners. Sanders hit a three to take a 3-2 lead, their only lead of the game here. And the Braves have had opportunities, Kirkland nailing a three from the corner to end the second quarter and send us to halftime here, but the Lopes have a 40-22 lead here as the Lopes are and the Braves at halftime right now. Marcos Canedo, 15 points for the Lopes, opened up an 18-point lead over the Braves here on GCU TV.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692. GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to GCU TV here. Lopes have a 40-22 lead over the Alcorn State Braves. We'll be right back here after another short break here on GCU TV.
I am Laura Lozoya, and I am majoring in biology with an emphasis in pre-med at Grand Canyon University. The dorm life at GCU definitely helped me build relationships, and I've made great friends on this campus. The quality education here is great. You're testing your limits, but you're going beyond them. It all comes together. The sciences, the ethics, and just everything. It's a beautiful thing.
Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Here, the Lopes have a 40-22 lead after Marcos Canedo has led the team with 15 points. She's 6 for 7 from the line. A lot of those points coming from the charity stripe. The Lopes have utilized 14 turnovers from the Braves to open up an 18-point lead.
Absolutely. And with what the Braves are going through, all those turnovers have definitely given up so many points that they could have had. And that is also thanks to the GCU defense. The Lopes defense has been, like we've said so many times tonight, absolutely on par, stellar tonight. In any formation that they have, they are not letting them get to that bucket. They're making them shoot outside the arc, and they're not, the Braves don't seem as comfortable with doing that as they do seeing going up to that net and trying to make the shots and layups and everything like that.
The Lopes have forced 7 steals as the Braves have committed 14 turnovers here in the game. 12 total fouls. The Lopes have gotten into some foul trouble, committing 15 fouls and turning the ball over 6 different times, but the Lopes have been able to be efficient from the field, 56% from the field for the Lopes to open up an 18-point lead over the Braves here as they lead Alcorn State 40-22 here at GC Arena. They are on.
Hey Phoenix, it's Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening. Grand Canyon University's newly remodeled golf course is thriving in the heart of Phoenix, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways, signature par threes, greenside bunkers, premium greens, and a brand new clubhouse and restaurant. Experience a university championship golf course this summer with great rates as low as $15 available now. Book your tee times at gcugolf.com. GCU is the university that never sleeps, moving at the speed of light. And now GCU is leading in the area of computer science and IT. With over 200 university degree programs across 9 colleges, on campus and online, join the most inventive concept in education today. Fast track options available with courses in cybersecurity, cloud computing, and systems architecture. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/IT.
Finding the right college isn't always simple. The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
I am Laura Lozoya, and I am majoring in biology with an emphasis in pre-med at Grand Canyon University. The dorm life at GCU definitely helped me build relationships, and I've made great friends on this campus. The quality education here is great. You're testing your limits, but you're going beyond them. It all comes together. The sciences, the ethics, and just everything. It's a beautiful thing.
Grand Canyon University. The quality of a private Christian education. The affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692. GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
And welcome back to GCU TV here. GCU Arena, Fletcher Like alongside Dewey Jeffries for the home opener for women's basketball. Basketball is back all the way through April as basketball season. It brings a lot of excitement and an increase in the atmosphere to college campuses, and it sure does that for GCU. Here as the Lopes have opened up a 40-22 lead over the Alcorn State Braves, led by Marcos Canedo, a transfer from Spain, essentially. She came in from South Florida as well. And the Lopes have utilized her 15 points and 3 assists to open up this 18-point spread. She's complemented well by Casey Rarick. But on the other side, Tia Sanders, 77 points for Sanders out of the 22. She's leading the team, and she's somebody that the Braves will really need to continue to look for offensively here if they're going to decrease the 18-point lead that the Lopes have. And here's some of the highlights from the first half. Canedo getting that steal and the open bucket. Here's her three-pointer that she drained and got to the foul. She made the free throw. One of Laramie's shots there. Laramie with 6 points, but she has 3 fouls. Tanisha Daniels right there on that basket. She had 3 fouls as well. That was Gajewski's first and only shot there. She drained that one. And a three-pointer there from beyond the arc. Rarick getting to the rack, a little teardrop that falls. August Tuchard, great ball movement out to Casey Rarick. She drains that three-pointer. Just great ball movement from the Lopes all game long. Relentless pressure defensively. As soon as the Braves are getting across half court, they're applying a fantastic and relentless half court press that's forcing 14 turnovers so far in the game, leading to 18-point spread thus far through one half.
Absolutely. Their defense is so strong that the offense of the Braves not being able to get through, even with the full court press, they're not being able to stop the Lopes from getting through them. The Lopes are sliding right through them and making sure that all of their shots and all of their execution as a team is well structured and well centered around them so that they can easily maneuver around the Braves as much as they need to.
Three starters in foul trouble. Really the only rust probably still on this Lopes team as they come out of the huddle with about 10 seconds left on the clock here before the second half starts. Offensively, they're working like an oiled machine. Defensively, even better. One of the best defensive performances we've seen in the two games we've seen so far out of this new Lopes team. With eight newcomers, they're fitting right into Trent May's defensive schemes and offensive schemes as well, moving the ball very well, like a hot knife through butter. The Lopes have opened up an 18-point lead here to start the second half as the Lopes will inbound the ball from about midcourt here in the second half of play. Anaya Baker passing to Laramie, who's back into the game. Laramie, Daniels, and Baker back on the floor, each with three fouls. Daniels will get the ball out to Canedo, and as the teams have switched sides, Canedo getting the ball to the rack. Her shot is no good, but an offensive rebound by Tanisha Daniels. But she's going to step out of bounds, and the Braves will get the ball.
What we're going to need to see from the Lopes right now is, especially with Laramie in, we're going to have to see them use these point shooters that they have and be able to not let them foul out. They already have, Judy has three fouls this half, and making sure that she can shoot the ball and get those points that the Lopes need without getting fouled, without fouling anybody, is crucial right now.
Sanders from the corner, her shot is no good. Canada with the rebound. Baker, her two-point shot is good. Her toe was on the line, so not going to be a three-pointer. Anaya Baker with 5 points now in the game. And the Braves will really want to attack at those three players for the Lopes that have three fouls. Three-pointer again from Tia Sanders is no good. Ball goes out of bounds, and the Lopes will retain possession.
Still seeing some aggression, actually, in this half at the beginning. With the speed of the game and with the speed of all the players on the court right now, GCU pushing offensively and defensively against the Braves. The Braves have been trying to fight back and press on the Lopes.
Canedo will work the ball up the floor. Tanisha Daniels up against the elbow, waiting for her team to run the play. And they'll start it all over and call a new play here. Canedo gets around the pick, takes it to the rack, and it's going to go out of bounds off of a Brave, however. Lopes will retain possession, 8 seconds on the shot clock. Lopes will need to do something quickly here off of the inbounds play. Gajewski was guarded nicely. Tanisha Daniels' shot is off target. Luton guarding Gajewski on that play. Luton decided not to shoot the ball from the corner. Freeman, jumper is good. Nothing but net there. As Freeman sinks the first shot that she takes here in the second half, she has four through the game. Gajewski gets the ball on the wing. Gets an eye on Baker, guarded by Freeman. Baker looking for her options. Finds Laramie. Laramie will pass the ball back to Baker, and Baker is fouled by Freeman. As the pass from Laramie wasn't the firmest of passes, but Freeman gets the arm of Baker, and the referee will call the foul against Freeman. Freeman with three fouls in the game thus far. She'll come out of the contest and sit on the bench.
Watching this Braves team on the court right now with this 18-point deficit is definitely showing to have a different effect on the court.
Baker's shot is no good. Off balance there from the transfer. Sanders looks to find rushing, but it's taken away by Canedo. Dangling the ball around, getting past her defenders. Nifty-nafty playing there from the Spaniard. Finds the Australian Gajewski, who gets it right back. Gajewski open for three, and she'll drain it. She's perfect from the field thus far. And Gajewski is playing very well. 7 points on three shots. 2 for 3 from the field, 2 for 2 from the line. And if you give Gajewski any room like that, she's going to bury it every single time. Baker gets the interception off of Sanders, out of bounds. Turnover there by the Braves. Lopes get the ball back. Wells back in the game. Didn't see Wells for very long. Only 10 minutes played there in the first half. She's back out on the floor, rushing 20 minutes. Just played about just about every single minute of that first half. Gajewski with 21 minutes. Gajewski to Canedo. Canedo driving to the hoop. Passes to Laramie. Laramie driving on rushing. No fouls called as her shot hit the underside of the backboard. Tolliver taking it down the length of the court. Dribbles it off of herself and out of bounds. Point for the Braves. Jubinville will come into the game. She's a junior from Monroe College. Averaged 22 points per game at the junior college from Alberta, Canada. A 6 foot forward here for the Braves. Canedo working the ball down to Laramie. Gives it away, but then gets it right back. Jump ball, and the possession arrow is in favor of the Braves. Injured player down on the floor for the Braves is Rushing. Rushing with 3 points in the game, all 3 points from the free throw line, 3 of 6 from the line, 4 rebounds, 3 turnovers, and 21 minutes played as she gets up, but she's going to be subbed out by Asia Kirkland, a freshman from Fresno, California, who drained a three-pointer at the end of the first half. Tolliver working on her leg as well. August Bouchard will come in for Canedo. Kirkland inbound. Tolliver wincing in pain right now as she's holding her right leg with her right arm, working the ball up the court. Tolliver working and looking for something, guarded by Gajewski, and she's going to pass that one out of bounds. Still holding her upper thigh, hunching over a little bit as she works back down the floor. August Touchard with the point guard good duties as Canedo got subbed out. Gajewski wide open for three. She buries it. But the foul is going to be called before the shot. Still waiting to see who it's on. Refs coming together and talking about the play. Fouls on number 14, Brianna Tolliver. Averaged 6.5 points per game last year. Gajewski's three-pointer is not going to stay. They're going to change who the foul is on. It's going to be on number 21, Gabrielle Jubinville, not number 14, Brianna Tolliver. Touchard to inbound. Finds Gajewski, gets around her defender Sanders. Little teardrop floater is good, and Gajewski's just getting started here with 9 now in the game. Started off slow, but she's coming on the scene making 2 baskets back-to-back, twice now. She now has 9.
Absolutely. With the technical foul that got her started in this game, it's definitely been the momentum she needed to definitely make her mark going into the second half.
Sometimes all it takes is one made basket, whether that's a free throw or a shot. Juski's line drive shot is off target, rattling off the rim. Wells with the rebound. Wells still with 0 points in the game. She averaged 5.1 points per game last year, 5.3 rebounds per game as well. More of a defensive player than an offensive player, named co-defensive player of the year in the SWAC as a preseason honor. Tolliver with the rebound there. Reset here with the new shot clock. Baker getting ready to check in. Sanders to Tolliver. Wells cutting to the basket. Doesn't get it. Tolliver's shot off the front iron and rebounded by the Braves. Jump ball here as Rarick, Daniels, and Touchard went in for it against Kirkland. Arrow points in the way of the Lopes. Timeout is called on the floor. Lopes open up a 47-24 lead over the Braves. 23-point lead for the Lopes here in the third quarter here on GCU TV.
Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
GCU dancers out on the floor right now as the Lopes have opened up a 47-24 lead over the visitors from Alcorn State. Laramie with 6 points, Kaneda with 15, Casey Rarick with 8, and Jessica Gajewski with 9. Gajewski really coming onto the scene late here in this game. Didn't have a shot until that technical foul was called, and she drained both of the free throws. And now she's got 9 after 2 made baskets here quickly in the second half. A 3-pointer send her to 9 points, but Kaneda with 15. She hasn't had a basket in a while, however, as the dancers get done, and the Lopes and the Braves are back out on the floor getting ready here. 4:33 on the clock. The Lopes with 9 steals in the game, 12 assists. Great ball movement from the Lopes. Unselfish play here in their first game of the season.
Looking to see a little bit more strong offensive playing from the Lopes right now. While they've had a lot of movement going around on their offense, they haven't necessarily had a lot of points going down to increase their game.
Lopes foul against Laramie, her fourth foul of the game. And foul trouble here in the third quarter, about halfway through the third quarter. Air ball there from the corner by the Braves. Kirkland gets the ball back. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Freeman with the ball working against Baker. Quickly moved there. Down to Sanders in the corner. Sanders' three-pointer is good and has cut the lead down to 20. Tanisha Daniels down low. Back out to Rarick. Rarick for 3. Off the iron. Rebounded by Laramie. Laramie for 3. Off the iron as well. Rebounded by Wells. Wells out to Freeman. Freeman working quickly. Freeman working against Baker. Driving to her right and then bringing it right back out. Jubenville with the ball against Baker. Wells with the ball through the legs of Daniels and she loses it. Daniels picks it up. Passes it off to Shishard.
Seeing a lot more press and defensive press from the Braves right now as the Lopes continue attacking with their offense to see if they can get even more of a lead on this team.
Laramie's turnaround jumper from the elbow is no good. Maya Baker had a wide open opportunity, decided not to take it. Now Freeman will push it up the floor, has Kirkland in the corner. Kirkland will dribble drive and put up a jumper and it's no good. Rebound by Touchard. Touchard signaling the play. A little bit of a man-to-man now from the Braves. Touchard guarded by Jubenville. Jubenville still on Touchard. Laramie down to Daniels. Daniels guarded by Kirkland. Her little post move down to the post is up and in off the glass. Daniels' first shot of the second half is good. She now has 4 through the game. Wells up top finds Jubinville, who almost lost it. Traveling there by Jubinville. Good call there by the referee. Three players coming in for the Lopes, Canedo, Gajewski, and Clark. Number 24, Kiara Clark, coming into the game. Clark will inbound to Canedo. Clark played in a minute earlier in the first half. Committed a personal foul before coming out. Canedo retaining the point guard duties. Finds Baker a little bit over the top there. Over the top of Freeman. Clark to the basket. Little teardrop floater off the rim a couple times and falls right back to Baker. Gets her own board. Guarded by Freeman up top. He's going to pick from Clark. Take it to the hoop. Stop and put it off the glass for two here. 51-27 lead for the Lopes. Freeman moving quickly. Guarded by Anaya Baker. Her shot is off target, and there's going to be a foul called against number 13, Canedo. That's two for Canedo, three for Clark, two for Rarick. Four fouls for Laramie. She's sitting right now. Clark will inbound. Canedo with 15, Rarick with 8, Gajewski with 9, and Baker with 6. Laramie with 6 rebounds as well. Canedo working against Sanders, passes it into the corner and out of bounds. Looking for Gajewski there, but wasn't able to find her. Murphy will check into the game here, coming in for number 11, Casey Rarick. Alcorn State is one of their last 7 from the field. They have 3 turnovers in their last 2.5 minutes. 2.5 minute drought as well. Freeman for 3 off the target and rebound Baker. Baker pushing up the floor behind the back there against Freeman. Into the corner for Gajewski. Gajewski pull up off the iron, out of bounds, and then off of Wells' hands. She's not happy about it. Not happy with herself after giving up that turnover with no pressure really against her. Baker to inbound. And it's thrown away off the inbounds play. And I'll go back to the Braves. Number 12, Luton to inbound. 4.1 points per game last year on 35% from the field. Had 1.8 rebounds per game, 23 total steals across the season. Freeman to inbound. The clock was still running, so they're going to start it all over. Put it back to 58 seconds and then to a minute. Number 12, Brianna Luton, still to inbound. Lopes lead 51-27 here. Under a minute to play in the third quarter. Second year of the quarter system in women's basketball. Wells throws it away. Great pressure there from Murphy and Clark to force that turnover. Trent May's happy about it. Murphy and Clark are happy about it as well. The Lopes now have the ball 47 seconds on the clock.
That's one thing we've been excited to see throughout this entire game is that the Lopes defense, no matter what is going on in this game, they have always been on top of things. They've been able to read who's getting the ball, put the pressure, double team them, whatever they've got to do, and get the ball in.
46% from the field in the game, 31% this half, so that's something to look at as the Lopes have increased their lead to 24. Foul is called against Clark on the missed opportunity there by Baker. Baker is 3 for 7 from the field. 6 points for number 1, a transfer from UC Davis. She had 14 points in the last game against Western State. Full court press here from the Lopes. Freeman will get the ball out to Wells after breaking that press. Wells will find Luton. Luton looking for an option. Back down to Wells. Freeman guarded against Canedo, and a foul is called against Canedo as Freeman got to the cylinder and wasn't able to get the ball up towards the rack as she was sent to the floor. 15 seconds on the clock as number 15 Freeman will go to the line. Transfer from Blinn Junior College, originally from Novosota, Texas, a 5'4 junior. Her first free throw is good. Freeman now with 5 points in the game, her first free throw in the contest. She has a rebound and 2 assists as well. 3 fouls. Second most turnovers on the team yet this game. Tolliver with 5. Second free throw from Freeman is good. Under 14 seconds on the clock, Clark. Off of Kajewski for 3. 7 seconds on the clock is no good. Rebound by Canedo. She'll put it back up, and she's going to get fouled with 3 seconds on the clock. Baker was guarded by Freeman in there. Got the ball to Gajewski in her shot off target, but an offensive rebound by Canedo gave the Lopes another opportunity. Now she's going to go to the line shooting 2 free shots here from the free throw line.
And this is why the coaches always tell you to go up and grab the rebounds, because it's in moments like this that the rebounds count for everything. You get the ball, even if you don't make the shot, you get fouled on, you get the rebound, and now you have an extra chance to make some more points on the board.
Second free throw is no good from Canedo. Freeman pushing up the floor. Buzzer goes off. Shot is not going to count. And the Lopes take a 52-29 lead into the third quarter break. Head into the fourth quarter. Lopes up 51-29 here at GC Arena.
Lopes, gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692. GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Lopes and the Braves here in the fourth quarter, getting underway. Tolliver with the ball up top, and Lopes are guarding them in a 2-3 zone.
That zone has been working for them all evening.
Down low shot there from Wells is no good. Rebound by Canedo. 4 rebounds for Canedo, 5 assists with 16 points. Daniels to Rarick, coming around the screen. Finds Canedo. Gets a screen but doesn't use it. Rarick in the corner for 3. It's good. A great shot opportunity there from the Lopes after a great ball movement and just being patient. Canedo dribbling and driving and then finding Rarick in the corner wide open as the Braves left Rarick open in the corner. Rarick now has 11 through the contest, and then the Braves are just going to send it out of bounds and throw it away here. Rarick and Marcos Canedo in double digits for the Lopes here in the contest. Laramie with 6 rebounds. Marcos Canedo with 4. She has 6 assists as well after that assist to Rarick. Rarick again, and she's going to drain another one. Rarick with 14 points here after two back-to-back three-pointers. Just wide open as the Braves let her go yet again defensively. With the point of the finger, Canedo, who has 7 assists in the game. Three-pointer there from Tolliver. And she's really holding just about every single part of her legs in pain right now, but she continues to score points, 6 points for the Braves. Baker guarded by number 23, Tori Spann. And then Baker's going to get wide open in the corner, her shot off target. Baker just let her go. He didn't even look at her. And the fast break opportunity for the Braves is good. Tia Sanders with the wide open layup. 34-58 now. The Lopes have a 24-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Rarick looking at her options. Screen down. Daniels with the ball. Gets Wells off the floor. Her shot no good. Spann working it down the floor, and then it's taken away by Canedo. Intercepted there by the Spaniard. Canedo finds Laramie. Laramie wide open. Great ball movement there from the Spaniard. Pumped up there. 16 points, 8 assists. Working on a double-double. And looking forward to that here. And those 10 assists would be spectacular here. And a double-double would be great for the point guard for the Lopes.
That well-oiled machine that is the Lopes right now is absolutely fantastic. Seeing them on offense and defense is just awe-inspiring, seeing what they're doing on the court.
Rarick is fouled as Canedo would pass it to her and then was undercut by a Brave. By number 20, Tia Sanders. Sanders now has 3 fouls in the game. She has 12 points as well, leading the Braves thus far. Kajewski with 9, 6 for Baker, 4 for Daniels, 16 for Canedo, and 14 for Rarick with 8 for Laramie. For 3 yet again, Casey Rarick, 9 points on 3 shots in a row. She's on fire right now, coming off the bench and scoring 17 points for the Lopes. And then gets a foul on the other end, Daniels, getting a charge there from Tia Sanders and forcing the turnover here in the fourth quarter. Foul is going to go on number 13. That's going to be a technical foul for Canedo. Tia Sanders will shoot 2. Here after the technical, 6:44 on the clock. Lopes leads 63-34, but that well-oiled machine is patience and ball movement. And Canedo's really the floor general right now as the point guard. 9 assists now after that pass to Rarick for 3. Rarick leading the team with 17 points, coming off the bench to score 17 points and lead this team. And really that's coming off of the ball movement from Marcos Canedo to get wide open looks for the Lopes.
Absolutely, and with Rarick with those 3 three-pointers back-to-back-to-back, jump to the top of the shooting list for the Lopes right now. It has been that energy and the momentum that the Lopes have needed to continue to keep this machine that they've got going strong against the Braves right now.
Rarick 5-for-7 from beyond the arc. Great numbers, 5 three-pointers. She's starting to look like Steph Curry out there with those 5 threes. Great three-point shooter for the Golden State Warriors. Wells throws that one away. Another turnover for the Braves. 2 Lopes now in foul trouble, however. Marcos Canedo with 4. Laramie with 4 as well. Tia Sanders for the Braves has 4 as well. August Touchard with the ball. Up top, working against Wells. She's going to get a screen from Laramie. She's going to shoot from way downtown. She's going to drain that one. The crowd is pumped up here as the Lopes have made multiple three-pointers in a row. An 8-0 run on over the last minute and 20 seconds opened up a 32-point lead here against the Alcorn State Braves. Rushing throws that one off the backboard, gets her own rebound. Her second opportunity is no good. Laramie with the rebound. And the Lopes are looking to slow things down here about midway through the fourth quarter.
Just as we've seen with the Lopes' defense, their offense this half has been absolutely on fire with all these three-pointers and the smoothness that the players play with, talking to each other, getting to the basket, making these points like Laramie just did. We're able to see exactly what the Lopes are capable of when they are at their optimum point.
Laramie now with 10 as well. Three Lopes in double-digit figures right now. Great ball movement, unselfish play from the Lopes. Nobody taking over as the MVP right now as the most valuable scorer in the game. 68 points for the Lopes. Laramie with 10. Rarig with 17. Marcos Canedo with 16. Gajewski with 9. She's had a really quiet night to score 9 points as well. Just a great performance so far from the Lopes here late in the game. 68-34. Freeman's shot, no good. Offensive rebound by Wells. Her shot is no good. Another offensive rebound. And she gets the shot off the ground to go. And the foul. She'll go to the line, shoot one. Lopes were on a 10-0 run there over the last 3 minutes, making 4 of their last 5 shots. Just great numbers. Lopes open up a 68-36 lead here at GCU Arena. You're on GCU TV.
The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
And welcome back to GCU Arena. Lopes have opened up a 68-36 lead over the Alcorn State Braves. But Laramie, she just fouled out. She has 10 points, however. She's going to exit the ball game and make room for another player to come in and make a statement. Lopes have had that happen as Laramie Daniels and Baker were in foul trouble all first half. Casey Rarick came onto the scene, scoring 17 points. She leads the team with 17, 5-for-7 from beyond the arc. Great numbers from the player coming off of an injury last year.
Absolutely. And the way that she has finessed in these shots into the net, making sure that she's perfectly wide open, no one's there looking for her. They pass the ball to her. She's wide open. She takes a shot. It's in every single time.
Canedo with 9 assists through the game so far, looking to get a double-double if she can get one more assist. A great unselfish player who also has 16 points, however. She can pass it and she can score. A great threat for the Lopes so far in the game. They've opened up a 32-point lead here in the home opener as basketball season has returned to the campus of Grand Canyon University and to campuses across the country as the Lopes and the Braves are getting set to come back on the floor. Wells will go to the line, shooting one after she made her third opportunity, second chance opportunities twice. Baker into the corner. Rarick passing up a three-pointer. Gajewski hopping, and she's going to get whistled for a travel as she set her feet with the ball, then jumped, decided not to shoot the ball, and then when she dribbled, got whistled for the travel. Sanders with the ball up top. She's going to find number 23, Tori Spann, and the shot there by the Braves is no good. Rebound by Baker. Baker now with 5 rebounds in the game, 6 points. Rarick up top looking for Bloom, then finds Gajewski. Baker working against Wells. August Touchard to Rarick. Rarick for 3. 6 three-pointers for Rarick. 20 points from Rarick. Great numbers. Career high, 20 points for Casey Rarick. What a performance off the bench. She's made 6 three-pointers. She's only missed 1. That was her first one of the game.
Absolutely. She's going absolutely all out for this game right now. She has come and realized this at the beginning of the season. She has showed up to this game, and Casey Rarick is here to play basketball.
She's showing what an offseason can do. Gajewski wide open for 3. She never misses those. She drains it. 12 points for Gajewski. 4 players for the Lopes in double digits as the Lopes are throwing in Katie Lee and Vanessa Murphy into the ball game here. Up 74-36, a 38-point lead. Wells with the shot, no good. Offensive rebound, though, by the Braves, and the shot is no good, but she'll go to the line. Foul against Casey Rarick for her third foul of the game. Tori Spann will go to the line. She shot 600. She shot 600 from the line last year, 60% from the free throw line. Averaged 5.1 points per game. Scored more than 10 six different times last year, and the Braves will really look for her to become a more clinical scorer here as the season winds down. She didn't score a single point today, and she missed that first free throw. Spann 0 for 1 in the game, 0 for 1 from the free throw line, 3 rebounds and a turnover, and she is shooting her second free throw. Her second free throw is no good as well. Rebound by Murphy. August Touchard with the point guard duties now. Erica Thomas getting ready to come in, a transfer from UConn. She played volleyball at UConn. Fifth-year senior. Gajewski for three yet again. Gajewski now 3 for 4 from beyond the arc and with 15 points. And all of a sudden, she'll hit two shots in a row and go from not really being an offensive threat to really being an offensive threat. She can lull you to sleep and then really wake you up in a hurry.
Absolutely. I don't know what it is with this Lopes offense right now, but they are burning up this court. They are lighting up these threes back and right and forward and left, and they are here to play.
The Lopes pushing the ball up the floor, up by 41 points after that three-pointer. August Touchard for three yet again. No good. Off the mark. Rebound by Jubinville. Up the floor to Kirkland. Kirkland, three players back. Blocking foul against August Touchard. And Kirkland will go to the line here after that foul. She's got 5 points. 0 for 2 from the line, however. The Braves are shooting 47.6% from the line. Lopes are 60% from the stripe, 50% from the field. And get this, they're holding the Braves to under 25% from the field. Great defensive numbers from the Lopes all game long. They're on a 9-0 run. 19-4 run over the last 5 minutes, and they're just smothering this Braves team, and they're scoring at will right now with four players in double-digit figures. August Touchard guarded closely by number 32, Hargrove. Alex Bloom up top, gets a screen from Thomas, but doesn't use it. The ball goes out of bounds. Lopes will retain possession. Lopes are 5 of 6 on their last 6 attempts. Alex Bloom gets the ball, gets to the floor. Foul against number 11 for the Braves. That's Alexis Holloway, a freshman from Gautier, Missouri. 5'9 guard for the Braves. Alex Bloom to inbound, looking for Katie Lee. She's going to toss it all the way out to August Touchard. Touchard will slow things back down with a new shot clock. Touchard guarded by Hargrove, then guarded by number 11, Holloway. Three-pointer from August Touchard is no good. Rebound by Katie Lee, and then given out to Alex Bloom. 1:45 on the clock. Bloom for three, and it's off target. Their wide-open opportunity for the Lopes. Ball is given back to the Lopes. Hargrove with the turnover. Erica Thomas and Vanessa Murphy forcing that turnover. August Touchard out of the game. Kiara Clark back in. The Lopes going big here with four players that are a lot taller than the Braves players. Vanessa Murphy, 6'1". Erica Thomas, 6'2". Katie Lee at 6'3". And Kiara Clark at 5'10". Just a defensive tower out there with five big forwards out on the floor for the Lopes. And then there's Alex Bloom at 5'5", a senior guard on the floor. Passes it into Kiara Clark. Personal foul, pushing off with the shoulder against number 32, Hargrove. And the foul would go against Kiara Clark. Give the ball back to the Braves here. Up 77-36, a minute 35 left on the clock.
You can see with the height advantage that the Lopes have put out there for their defense that they want their defense to keep the Braves at their bay, keep them at bay. So what they've done is they brought out the height for their defense. to make sure that the Braves cannot make any more points in this last couple of seconds.
No plays off here as the Lopes are looking to increase the lead and play smothering defense. Ball's going to go out of bounds. Great attempt there by Erica Thomas, however. And just to remind you, the next women's home game will be here in GCU Arena on November 25th against the University of Denver in the GCU Thanksgiving Invitational. Women play at noon on the 25th, followed by the men at 7 p.m., a doubleheader here as the men will take on Coppin State. And the Lopes women's basketball team takes on the University of Denver. Those are the next two basketball streams here on GCU TV coming on November 25th. And the Lopes men's team takes on the number one team in the country, Duke, at Duke in North Carolina. I'll play in front of the Cameron Crazies. Duke coached by Coach Krzyzewski, winningest coach in NCAA Division I history. First coach to 1,000 wins. Kirkland making the first free throw. She'll go to the line for a sixth time. And she makes it yet again. 2 for 6 from the line. 7 points for Kirkland in the game. Alex Bloom pushing the ball up the floor with under a minute to play. Lopes up 36 points here in the home opener. Katie Lee to Erica Thomas. Erica Thomas's shot no good. Bench off their seats on Erica Thomas's shot. Erica Thomas did not have a point in the first game, the exhibition game. She did have a block, however, in 3 minutes. A transfer from UConn, a volleyball player at UConn, not even a collegiate basketball player. Her first collegiate basketball game under her belt right now. Katie Lee, the inbounds pass, and it's blocked there by Holloway. Foul here with 33.8 seconds on the clock. It's going to go against number 20, Vanessa Murphy, a freshman from just down the road at Xavier Prep, a 6'1 freshman from Phoenix, Arizona. The first free throw from number 12, Luton, is good. Brianna Luton averaging 4.1 points per game last year. She has 3 here in this game. Her second free throw is no good. Rebound by Murphy. And Bloom, as the point guard, will bring the ball up the floor.
This last 30 seconds is prime to see what the Lopes players are going to do, what their strategy is going to be.
Kiara Clark with a turnover there. Alex Bloom then made the three-pointer. It will not count, however. 77-42 here, 19.1 seconds on the clock. And this one is just about over and done with here, waiting for the final buzzer as the Lopes have opened up the season with a win here. 77-42 as Kirkland gets a steal from Kiara Clark. And then she'll lay it in. 44 points for the Braves, 77 for the Lopes. Lopes opening up the season with a win, a 33-point victory over the Alcorn State Braves. 20 points for Casey Rarick. She led the team coming off the bench. A fantastic performance from Rarick. 6 three-pointers from the guard off the bench. What was working for Rarick?
You know what, Rarick just had, she came in, missed that first shot. All the rest of her shots went in like butter, easy, nice and smooth. She just got in the zone. She came, she realized, you know what, I'm not going to miss another shot today, and she did. She came back and kicked butt.
Casey Rarick, 6 three-pointers. Marcos Canedo, 17 points, 9 assists. Court general here for the Lopes, and we'll look to see that all season long. Canedo just assist away from a double-double, but the Lopes open up the season with a 77-44 win over the Alcorn State Braves. A fantastic performance from the Lopes. 4 different Lopes in double-digit figures. Fantastic performance from the Lopes offensively, and a fantastic performance defensively as well, holding the Braves to 44 points. I'm Fletcher Like alongside Dewey Jeffries. For everybody in the production booth, have a great Veterans Day weekend. We thank everybody and all the veterans in this country for their support and their hard work and their service here for our great country. 77-44 win for the Lopes here in their opening game of the season. Have a great weekend, everybody.